directly correlated to the character and weight of his sin on earth.
Thank you.
Wife is the second of four movements in the Divine Comedy. Dante, having completed his journey through the Inferno, is brought by Virgil to the shores of the island mountain Purgatory in the midst of the Southern Ocean. The mountain is comprised of seven terraces, each representing one of the seven deadly sins. In each terrace, sinners are given an appropriate penance which is symbolically tied to their transgressions on earth. The sufferings endured are accepted voluntarily by the spirits in atonement for their sins. As Dante and Virgil continue up the mountain, they feel a violent quaking at which all the spirits proclaim, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Dante learns that the quaking signals the completion of one soul's penance, for which all other souls give thanks. The completion of the penance allows the souls to ascend to Paradiso, heaven, taking his or her rightful position in relation to God.
Thank you.
prepared for his journey to Paris. Beatrice, his guide, lifts her eyes toward the sun. Following her example, Dante looks to the sun and is at that moment transformed in preparation for his great adventure. He is surprised to discover wonderful music, the music of the spheres, surrounding them. Swifter than thought, their flight of incredible speed begins. Dante and Beatrice, accompanied by sounds of wondrous beauty and intensity, ascend to the sphere of fire.
Thank you.
flesh to represent those beams of light. Beginning with a single tone or beam, the intensity grows with each entrance until we are surrounded by lights of multiple colors and complexities. As the light engulfs the listener, we are presented with the sound of joy, peace, love, and hope, growing ever brighter as the journey through the spheres progress. As the listener arrives at the Empyrean, the region of pure light, the music of the spheres, first introduced in the Ascension Movement 3, is restated in brilliant fashion by the brass section. The light continues to intensify as the woodwind colors swirl around the brass figures. The sights and sounds grow even brighter as Dante sees a river of light which is transformed into a great rose at whose center is the wonderful source of the light. Upon the petals are seated the saints, clad in the whitest of robes. Angels fly like swarms of bees up from the heart of the rose to the petals, their faces of living flame, their wings of gold, their bodies white as the purest snow. Dante looks to the highest tier, where Mary sits enthroned, surrounded by a thousand joyful angels. Mary is surrounded by the heroines of the Old Testament, Eve, Rachel, Sarah, Rebecca, Judith, and Ruth. On Mary's opposite side are the male figures of the Christian era, John the Baptist, St. Francis, St. Benedict, and St. Augustine, as well as Adam, Peter, Moses, and John the Apostle. The lower tiers of the rose are filled with thousands of infants, purified into glorious innocence. With a gracious smile from the Virgin Mary, Dante permitted the beatific vision. He lifts his eyes towards the heart of the rose. Within one blinding light, he recognized three separate lights in the form of interlocking circles, symbol of the Trinity. Within one circle, he perceived the dim image of a human face, a reminder that God, through Christ, lives and still lives as man on earth.
Thank you.